Hi everybody, today I want to have a quick conversation. I want to have a quick sort of idea sharing discussion with you, and I'm inviting you to comment in the comment box below to talk about agility. And while I'm driving to work here in early morning, it's stuck in a traffic jam, so probably this is the best time to do some reflection and do some thinking. That's what I usually do when I drive to work, and this is a time when I can sort of ponder some thoughts in my mind. And agility is certainly ranks in the priority of many business leaders' agenda and many business leaders' thinking. And certainly agility in HR has become a very, very important talking point. But why agility matters so much? And why agility matters so much in HR? That's an important sort of a conversation starter. First of all, agility is never a goal. Agility is just simply a mean to an end. The goal is not to become agile, the goal is to win at the marketplace. The same way for HR, the goal of HR is not to be agile, the goal of HR is to enable and help business win and support business on the journey in this ever-changing and disruptive marketplace. So one thing for sure, that today is the slowest day of the forthcoming future. And the change, the pace of change will just accelerate as we progress. So organizations face tremendous challenges, not just in form of technology changes, disruption, digitization, generations at the workplace. There are just so many external and internal sort of forces shaping literally every organization and every industries that it's quite challenging to keep up with the pace. Potentially, agility can be the answer. But what is agility in the first place? I was fortunate enough to participate masterclass with Dave Ulrich a couple of months ago. And the topic of discussion was agility. And basically, what we agreed upon, there is no universal definition for agility, but what we agreed upon is that we can agree on and we can talk about agility when there are three conditions fulfilled. One, we are able to anticipate in the future. Two, becoming adaptable to change and continuously open to change. And number three, always learning. So anticipate the future, be adaptable, and always be ready to learning so you can help your organization to win a marketplace. It is also very, very important to differentiate when it comes to agility. It's not just about agility at the individual level or organization level, but there are four levels of agility. Number one is strategic agility. Am I competing in the right game? Am I playing the right game? Am I in the right business in the first place? Or am I just inventing a better mousetrap? So how agile my organization capabilities are in regards to finding out what the right strategy and where our strategic focus should be. Number two is organizational agility. Is my organization set up to support my strategic implementation of the strategy, my strategic agility? Do I have the right structure in place? Do we have the right culture of agility? Number three is individual agility. Do I have the right people to support the organization in this exciting journey? And particularly in culture, and that's where HR professionals play a major role, to create the culture of agility. Because the biggest challenge with agility has got to be a mindset. You've got to have an agile mindset in our people. But the biggest challenge is while everything is visible on a behavior level, on a mindset level, it's really not. So how do I install this agile mindset in our people? Probably that's a big challenge. And here comes number four, is HR agility. Do I have the right people processes? Do I have the right HR processes in place to support organizational individual agility that enable implementing the strategic agility of my business? So it's a very, very complex question. And there are many potential pitfalls along the way. And probably first and foremost, it does require change. And while generally everybody sort of wants change for improvement and wants change to do things in a more productive way, but overall, change experts probably will agree with me that nobody wants to change. I mean, the resistance to change is enormous. And even beyond that, when it comes to leading change, that's probably an even more challenging question. Who wants to lead the change in the organization? However, agility cannot be achieved without change. So it's a very, very complex question on how to achieve overall organization agility and how HR needs to change to support the organization in winning in a marketplace by installing agility in HR function, agility in the organization. Please do share with me your comments, your thoughts, your ideas, and where you potentially see agility can fail. What is the best way to start? What would you suggest for the community? And let's just start a conversation about agility in HR, agility in organizations. Thank you for watching.